bonus episode? Is that,
yes.
Yeah, that's what we're going to call it. Bonus episode today. So there's a hashtag going around for vloggers, sewing vloggers, started by the I'm reading stuff, sorry. The Camden Stitcher.
People can see that you're reading stuff.
Yeah, okay. And the Specky Seamstress, they put together sort of a question.
Questionnaire?
Yeah, a list of questions and like a questions like challenge to sewing vloggers, and we thought we'd take part. But there is actually more than 10 questions. There's 37. So we're going to do it a bit different. I'm going to pass this phone to Mike, and Mike's just going to pick randomly and tell us which and ask us the questions.
Yeah, so I haven't seen the questions.
No. I've got a rough idea of what's going on, but we just thought it's called so many question tag, and we just thought
we'll put the thingy in the description box.
Yeah, we'll put links and all stuff. That. Yeah. And we'll, but we're only going to do 9.
Yeah.
So 3 each.
3 each, yeah.
Yeah, because you don't want to hear us for that long. Right. So I'm going to pass it to Mike now. You get to hear his lovely Polish accent. Like, it'll be brilliant.
You don't have a typical Polish accent.
No, but he's got a nice voice.
Yeah. So Mike is there. We will be looking at Mike all the time?
Oh, yeah, I don't know. We'll just try and be professional, okay?
Like we are.
Yeah.
Professionals like we are. Yeah. Okay. Mike, hit us with a question, not like actual. That would hurt.
All right, Louise, proudest make or moment?
I suppose proudest make / moment. Oh my god, I don't know actually. Probably my otter dress.
So
back in So Over It, I did a vlog with them and we had Spoonflower fabric and we made the Charlotte dress. I made the Charlotte dress out of this gorgeous otter fabric.
And it's amazing.
And that's probably my proudest make. Or this could be my proudest make. Pat and Pals. I quite like that. I made an excuse to hang out with my mates once a month.
Yeah.
And I make them join me.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty good.
That's nice.
But yeah, probably my old dress is probably. Because that's the moment I was like, actually, I can fucking sew.
And also, you look gorgeous in that, like, proper gorgeous in that dress.
Thank you.
I like it. Yeah, definitely. Okay.
Good one.
Next one.
All right, Barbara, what's your most favorite and least favorite sewing task?
Favorite would be just finishing
everything
in the nicest way possible.
A bit of bias binding.
Bias binding, facings, overlocking things, French seams.
Yeah, you do love that.
Everything that you have to be like very precise. Least favorite. I want to say unpicking. That's not really a thing. That's just when I make. I don't like it when I make a mistake. But technique buttonholes probably still. My machine does it all for me. It's still just something that I'm like, need to do buttonholes. There's no reason for it.
Yeah, I think it's also the fact you go to buttons on and then you go to sew the buttons on.
Yeah.
That might be it. I don't know what it is.
I do think you're alone.
I think you're... No.
I would rather stitch in a zipper than do buttonholes.
So. I like putting in zips.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't like putting in zips.
Yeah.
There you go,
Mike. I bet you never knew that.
Yeah.
All right, Lisa. How do you store your patterns?
Oh, I'm not very organized. That's why he's picked this question. Thanks, husband. I do have a filing cabinet. So for my PDF patterns, I've got them all in envelopes in a filing cabinet. The paper patterns aren't massively organized. I have a cupboard, and they kind of live in the cupboard, but the cupboard's a bit
chaotic
and it's a bit overstuffed. And then I have a couple of the cardboard IKEA boxes that I've got them in as well. So there's not really a system.
But do you know where everything is?
Sometimes. 9 out of 10 times I can usually remember where I put it.
Yeah.
Not always. So I could be better organized. I have, like, I still, because I went back and I kind of organized all my PDF patterns so they were easier to find, and I labeled all the envelopes and stuff, and now I've been a bit lax with it recently, so I need to kind of go back, because what happens is you make something and then I have a really bad habit of just leaving the pattern pieces everywhere and not putting them back. And then you just like get, and especially like, you know, when I make stuff for work and things, like, it's just like, you know, oh, like, that's a nice big pile of patterns, that's great. So then you have to go and organise it. So obviously it would be easier if you did it at the end every time you finished it, but yeah, one day.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's how I organise them. Not really. Okay.
Right, Louise, what's the one piece of advice you would give yourself if you could go back to when you first started sewing?
Maybe just be slightly less ambitious. Like, at the beginning, like, be a bit nicer to yourself.
Yeah, that's
something simpler. Like, I think the first dress I made was like a finished shawl dress, and it was just like, I look at it now, and then I'm like, oh my god, what was I doing? But maybe that was good because it forced me to do it. But yeah, just like, maybe take the time just to learn the basics first rather than doing it the other way around.
Because it can sometimes, I can imagine it would put you off, because then you get
frustrated, and then you think you can't do it, and you can, and a lot of it is just learning and practice.
So I'm still uncomfortable with sips. Generally, I watch a YouTube video on how to do sips every time I do sips, because I still haven't got the confidence in the sips because of that first make. So where if I maybe had done it like more traditionally, then I would be less like thingy about sips.
Oh, you'll get there.
I will be. I just need to keep doing it. Yeah. But actually, it doesn't hurt to watch the YouTube video.
No, it's nice, not at all.
Little friend showing you how. But yeah, probably that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think I answered the question.
Yeah. Totally. Okay.
All right, Barbara. How about...
He's not sure. He's like...
There's a lot of questions.
He's looking at the phone.
Not sure.
Pick one.
What about planner or improviser?
That's an easy one. Planner.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah.
She has like lovely like printouts and everything.
Yeah, you're like everything. my ideal of being organised.
But only with this sort of stuff. Only with sewing and my work, which is sort of the same thing for me. But in that stuff, I've got organised. The kitchen, however, or the rest of my house, or none of that.
At least you're organised somewhere.
Yes. But yeah, no, I do like to plan. I like to... I've got, actual notebooks. I'm one of the few people that has, got a pen and write things down. And got a daily diary, and then I've got the planner for my mix, so I like to make notes in that as well. And... yeah, I can't help it. I don't do it on purpose. It's just the way what I like to do.
Yeah.
So, don't be jealous. It's just in nature, sort of.
Yeah, it's never going to be that way.
I'm not trying. It's just the way.
It just comes to you. It's who you are.
Yeah. Who I am. but yeah, not a very interesting answer, I'm sure, but yeah.
I think it is interesting.
Yeah.
I think you're interesting.
Thank you very much.
Oh, man.
Hey, do you want to go out on a date someday?
Yeah, sure.
Sorry for leaving you out. You can come too.
You can come too.
You can come to the date.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cool.
What's your proudest make or moment?
Oh, well, that's easy. That's my wedding dress. That was a lot of work, but it was worth it. Definitely.
You know what we should do? I say we, but you always make the you put the things in the comments or whatever.
Maybe we can put pictures on the video. Can we do that? I'm asking Mike because he's the tech man.
Yeah, and if that doesn't work, we can always put links to our Instagram.
Yeah,
but you have to see Lisa's dress. That's basically stunning. why I came up with this idea.
Beautifulness,
like prettier than Cinderella. Yeah. Like Cinderella was, even though she was Cinderella was first, like.
Yeah, which,
it's based on Lisa's dress.
Yeah. So good.
Yeah, It's our favorite make as well. You can tell.
Another easy one. Do you have any pet helpers?
Yeah. I have two cats called Elsa and Ghibli. And they love any sort of fabric putting down. And Elsa, I've shared her on Instagram quite a lot. If she hears the sewing machine, she runs to come to the sewing machine. Because she likes likes pulling the pins out.
Oh, okay. Well, that's
like helping. So as the machine's going through, yeah, she's like getting them out with her claws. Like, she just likes getting them out. So, you know, when you're feeding, so I'm naughty, I pin and then I sew over the top. And she's pulling it out on the other side. Julie would tell me I was naughty. How I know I'm naughty. So she likes that. She just loves the sewing machine. Just loves it. And now that I've got my own little sewing space, the cats, you just open the door and the cats are there. So I've got that. The guinea pigs don't get involved. They're just downstairs. They're in the garden. But maybe if we let them out in the house, they might like it too.
I do think they'd want to hang out with the cats though.
And the fish are indifferent. So I've got a lot of pets and they're indifferent. But the cats, definitely. You know cats. If you put anything like down.
They're like, oh, you want that there? Oh, let me knock it off for
you. They just sit. So,
let me sit on it.
I still need to meet them. All of them.
Do children count as pets? No, I'm joking.
I was thinking about that when she said, like, oh, I'm just going to sit on it. I was like, it reminds me of someone. Next question.
A bit more of an open-ended one. What are your biggest sewing hopes or challenges?
For me? Ooh.
It's quite deep.
No, it's a fully me-made wardrobe, everything. I don't want that right now, and it's not going to work for me this year, and probably also not next year, because I still have a lot of ready-to-wear pieces in my wardrobe that are absolutely fine.
Yeah.
But what I would like is to, if I do need to replace something, then I make it myself. So in a few years' time, and even the wardrobe that I have now, I've got quite a few handmade pieces already. That took me years.
Yeah.
So even in a few years' time, if I by then have a handmade winter coat, a handmade summer coat or jacket, because I still haven't made those, so that is sort of on my list. And then jeans, another thing that I haven't made yet. If I then, you know, over the years, if I can replace those, that would be awesome. And to just be, like, fully me made.
I think that's everything. A dream, isn't it? Really?
Yeah, I think so. And, yeah, so far, I mean, jeans is one of the things that I still buy, so that I would like to make that in the near future. And sort of, what do you call, like, an in-between coat? Not summer,
like a,
not...
Like a jacket.
Sort of, I've been looking at the Eden coat. Eden? Yeah, to the end of the buttons. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And, or maybe, like, the Kelly anorak, or nice in-between coat.
Yeah.
So that might be, sort of, in terms of, like, plans, that is...
Sooner.
Yeah. One of the first bigger projects that I want to do. Yeah.
Awesome.
So, yeah, we'll see how that goes. But yeah, hope that I that was the that was the question, right? Yeah. What was the question again? But no, it's fine.
And finally, an easy one. Paris or New York?
Oh, well, that's easy. Paris. I love Paris. Well, I mean, we got engaged in Paris and went there for my 30th birthday. It's my favourite city ever. Yeah. And there's lots of cake.
Yeah.
So that's...
And there's lots of everything that I love, like food-wise.
Yeah. I've never been.
Oh, we should do this for our first date.
Yeah.
We should go to Paris, the three of us.
Yeah.
Just I would love that.
All of the pastry.
Pastry, bread, cheese,
wine.
It's heaven.
Yeah.
I've never been. I don't know how I've never got there, but I just haven't.
It's one of my, and it's just so, I mean, I'm sure, I haven't been to New York. I'm sure New York's lovely, but Paris is just fucking beautiful, and you cannot, I don't think it's comparable.
No, it's not.
It really is.
Years ago, but it's not, it can't
You can't compare. Yeah. And ignore what people say about Parisians. They're really lovely. They're not any ruder than any Londoners that I've met. So so if you haven't been, go.
I'll do that.
Yeah.
Fashion-wise as well, because that's probably the context.
Oh, yeah.
What's that place that you went in Paris and it had all the embroidery threads and the little...
Sajou? Maison Sajou?
It was
the cutest embroidery shop. It was like, and it was full with loads of like different threads and things, and obviously because it's an embroidery shop, they also had patterns, and it looked like you kind of stepped back in time. Like, I had lots of little cupboards filled with lots of different things. I think you can buy them online, and also I think they're stocked in Liberty as well.
And
did you find them somewhere?
Yeah, Beyond Measure.
So it's really pretty stuff. Yeah. So yeah, have a look at that as well if you like.
If you're like pretty vintage.
And packaging and stuff. Yeah. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Awesome. Cool. But definitely, let's plan this.
Yeah. Pat and Pals on tour.
Yay! We could do it. That would be so awesome. Yeah.
But like one day.
Yeah, you could go there and back in a day. You don't have to stay over.
I would like to go with someone who knows what there is, because then I can see.
Yeah, let's do it for a day. We might be able to get cheap Eurostar tickets. Or something
before Brexit. Plan this. Yeah, let's plan this.
And then go fabric shopping.
Spend all the money. So that's our... We've done our 9 questions.
We're done.
9 because keeping count.
See, because we're chatty Cathys, this is why we're not doing the full questions, because it would be a very long video.
And then you'd be like, oh man, I'm going away now.
Yeah.
I just thought of something that I wanted to say. If I am allowed.
Of course. I love you too.
Damn it, she's already married.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So we've been talking about what other videos we want to make in the future. Oh, yeah. And because it's not always possible for us to release a new video every 2 weeks, that is possible, but to make something completely new every month. I mean, some months are just really busy. So what we would like to do is film extra videos like this one, and let us know if you liked it, and also if you've got ideas for other videos that we
could do. Would you like to see our other makes that we've got in our wardrobe that aren't necessarily pattern pals?
Yeah, maybe we've done Q&A. Do you want us to talk about our favourite patterns that we've made? Or...
And maybe, we talked about this before, but, we might do it one day, but for now we're thinking about other things than doing... like instructions, what you call, like what you watch, like the videos that tutorials. How to do is tutorials. There are so many tutorials out there already, so I think we might do that one day, but for now we are looking for something other than tutorials, but that is still fun to watch. Or maybe you want to see
things that we find interesting, like, you know, other
patterns,
videos,
or we can even go through patterns well.
Or things people have made, like blog posts, Instagram posts, like if you want to see a roundup of our favourites for the month or something like that.
Yeah.
Let us know.
But, we just want to bring more to you, and
we just want to make sure that we kind of keep posting our
Because we love making the videos, but then I know for me personally, it's not always that easy to make a garment.
Yeah, and nobody wants stress. Yeah. Like some months are just busier than others. Yeah. Sometimes it's a more complicated thing that we're making.
So we want to buy ourselves more time.
Sometimes it's just like our schedules just don't work for three people, you know, and the time to film it and then also get it out. So
So we want to buy ourselves more time, but also still bring the content for you. So any ideas, please let us know in the comments below. That would be brilliant.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And
that was very good.
Yeah. We'll see you soon.
Bye.